Hello everyone and welcome to a new IBMI RPG sample video. I'm sure that in most of your programs you use the monitor opcode to catch possible errors in execution. It is a very good way to make your programs run without ending abnormally. Recently I've seen that in some cases we can use the onExit opcode to capture errors. This is not a monitor replacement because with monitor we have more control over our code. But in some cases, it's great to have the possibility of cleaning our work before ending the program because an unexpected error. In this video, I'm going to show you an example of how to do it. Let's go. Well, I have made a small program where I'm using the monitor opcode to catch possible errors. Let me show it to you. As you see, I'm using VS Code. Let me show it to you. Is this one? Well, as you've seen, this program is a non-cycled program, as you can see here. Okay. I have a main procedure, and there I'm calling to a sub-procedure three times that is going to make a calculation. In the sub-procedure, if the calculation fails, then I'm catching the error with the monitor sentence. And I'm sending a message to the job log. Well, using monitor, the program will run the sub procedure in all cases, even if the parameters makes the operation fail. For example, if you are making a division by zero. Well, imagine that while I'm running my sub procedure, I'm getting an error that is not expected. For example, something that makes our session ends. In that case, my program will end, and anything that was halfway done will not end. And for example, if I have created a temporary file, it will remain. If I have not saved a data, it will not be saved, etc. And what's worse, if it's a program that should have been running in the background, you may never know why it hasn't finished. For all these cases, which may occur on very few occasions, we can use onExit. onExit is an opcode that allows you to run a section of code every time a procedure ends. Not a program, a procedure. And this can be a main procedure or a sub-procedure. And when I say every time, it's every time. I mean, it will run whether it ends normally or abnormally. And the best part is that I can put an indicator after the onExit opcode that the program will use as an error indicator, and checking if it is activated or not, I can do whatever I need. So for example, in my program, I can add onExit this way. For example, first thing I have to do is to declare my indicator. And here I add the onExit sentence with the calculation error indicator. And if calculation error is activated, then I will run what I need. For example, I can send a message. For example, this, okay? For example, this way the sub-procedure will run in the same way. But if something wrong happens in the middle of the execution, then the calculation error indicator will be activated and the program will run whatever I write in this part. Okay? For example, here I'm sending a message to the job log, but imagine you can, for example, free memory from any pointer that we have, or close files, or saving information into a log file, anything. Great. Well, let me compile the program, and I'm going to try to show you an example of how it works. Let me compile it. Okay. Now let's go to the green screen. Well, let me start a debug session And let me stop the program here. And let's run it. Okay. I am going to run the program into the calculation sub-procedure. And what I'm going to do is to put here, stop this, the program here, okay? Because this is the only way I can go inside into the on-exit section, okay? Well, and now what I'm going to do is to open a new session. I'm going to close my session from the older session, so the program will end. Let's see what is going to happen then. Well, as you can see, in the other session I'm running the program, and what I'm going to do is to close it immediately. And if I go to the other session, if you see, I'm in this line because the program is ending. And also, if I see, the indicator has been activated, so I can go, run this piece of code, and as the indicator is activated, then I'm sending this message to the job log. Okay? And after the procedure ends, then the program is ending and the session is ending too. If I see the other session, the program has ended. Well, as you see, this is a very good way to save possible execution problems which we don't expect. For example, unexpected closures of the system or my session. I hope you liked the video and that it was useful to you. As always, remember to like and subscribe if you aren't already. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching.